Hello and welcome to another vlog. 2020 has been tough. You know, we have been stuck for almost 6 months in our houses. Things have started improving in Oman, so we thought of making this small trip. So this is how we're going to show you how to travel during 2020. The place we have chosen is Jabel Akhdar, so we will be camping overnight over there. It's a second highest mountain in Middle East. It's at roughly around 2,800 meters, and it's quite chilly over there. Right now in Muscat, it's almost 36 degrees Celsius, while in Jabel Akhdar, it should be around 22. The forecast says that it's going to rain, so let's enjoy the ride and the trip, and let me show you how to camp during 2020. Camping is the safest way of traveling, so let's do it. Update, we have been driving for I think 45 minutes now, and we have reached a place called Bidbid. Now Bidbid is significant because that's where you take a left if you're going towards Wahiba Sands. We're going to continue straight on the Muscat Nizwa highway, and Nizwa would be around 110-120 kilometers from here. Don't quote me on that, but yeah, in a couple of hours time we should be starting our ascent on the Jabel Akhdar mountains, and then it would be probably 40-45 minutes before we reach the mountain peak where we would like to set our camp for tonight. So next update in few minutes. We'll start our ascent now. We're hungry, it's already 2. So we just stopped at one of the burger joints to take something for our lunch. Aiva, Wahab and Wahab vegetable burger. Okay. And thank you. have just crossed the police checkpost at the foothills of Jabel Akhdar. There's a police checkpost where you have to give your national ID card and driving license. They will also check whether the car is a four-wheel drive or not, because only four-wheel drives are allowed on this mountain, because the roads are very steep. You know, while going down, it's mandatory to be on a four-wheel low gear, otherwise it's difficult to manage the weight of the car going down with just the brakes. We are almost there. We just stopped at a viewpoint which comes probably, I think, 15-20 minutes before you reach the peak. So we have just parked the car. We'll enjoy the view and we'll show you the view as well. So as you can see, the weather is amazing. You know, when we started from Muscat, it was almost 40 degrees. And right now it's 29, and probably another 5 degrees will go down when we reach the top. Here you can see some mountain goats. And there you can see some police checkpoints, you know, because Corona isn't over, you know, so social distancing has to be maintained, and police is taking around everywhere and educating people as to how to behave in crowded places. We'll give the car a rest as well, because the car was under heavy revving for last half an hour, 45 minutes. The ascent is quite steep, you know. I'm not sure if the camera would have been able to do the justice or not, but those are straight 30-35 degrees inclined, and the engine really revs and gets hot when going up. So guys, we have finally reached the top of Jabel Akhdar Mountains. On your left, you will be able to see Alila Jabel Akhdar. That's one of the most prominent hotels in Oman and on the peak of Jabel Akhdar. It's a five-star hotel. Now, we are scouting for a good location which is overlooking a nice cliff to set up our camp. And once we find it, we will let you know. Guys, we think we have found a good location. It's right on the cliff. We need to see a flat surface, but for that we'll have to do a bit of off-roading. So let's engage four-wheel and then let's go. Okay, so four-wheel is engaged now. We will take this route. Thank you. So guys, I think we have found a good location for camping. It's right at the cliff. We can't take the car much further because the stones are quite big. So we've taken it as much as we can, and let me show you this. So the car is parked here. That's the maximum I could take it back, because you see these rocks are quite big. And currently, yes, we are standing on a rock, but that's fine. So that's the road, and we have done some off-roading, and we have brought the car way up over here in the mountains. Now let's go and check out our spot where we'll camp. That's our driver, by the way. She drove us all the way. And let's just see. It's quite rocky, but the good thing is that you have a lot of tabletops where you can set up your tent and other stuff. So that's where we were thinking, you know, this is a good location around here to camp. The car is here, so we can easily bring stuff from the car, and the main light which we'll be putting in will be from the car. So I think a light on top of the car over there should be sufficient to illuminate this entire area. Now, the good thing is, let's look at the view. So guys, this is called the Grand Canyon of Middle East. Let's look at the view. We are surrounded by the mountains from all the sides. And yep, that's the major cliff going down. It's pity that we were not able to bring the car over here, because this is a perfect location, you know, right at the cliff, and then camp over here. But hey, who could complain? Even the car brought us here. That's more than enough. So we'll camp over there and probably hit out just for a bonfire or evening walk closer to the cliff. But yeah, all in all, good location to be in. So guys, we have finally started unboxing. So we have everything, you know. We have the big tent. That's where we will sleep. There's a small tent. This is the changing room or toilet, whatever you say. This is everything what we need to eat. This is our bed, our table. We have already put the water over there, and Sathki is putting other stuff. So let's unbox everything and let's set up our camp. And look at her. Look at her.
A few moments later.
So we are at a new location. Sorry, but the location we chose earlier was right on the top of the mountain, and it was too windy. You know, our tents and the pop-up arrangement which we had, we couldn't sustain it. The wind was just putting them down. So we have come a bit down. We are actually at a very nice location. There is water body next to me, behind me. You can see the reflection of the light. In the morning, I'll be able to show you a better understanding of where we are. And it's quite chilly. It's around 16-17 degrees. We have done our setup, so you can see our halogen running. That's the halogen on the car. We have our tent set up over here, so this is where we'll change and do our stuff. And we are now starting our barbecue and our fire. So stay tuned, we'll show you a lot more which is installed. This is our setup. So this is for making fries and morning breakfast. This is additional light we have. This is our music system. So yeah, let's get the party started, shall we, Sathki?
Yes, please. Can't wait.
2 moments later.
So guys, quick update. We have finished our dinner, and everything is done. We have packed our stuff, kept it in the side, and we have set our bed. So if you look behind me, that's the full-fledged bed behind us. So that's the Intex inflatable, the air bed. And luckily, it's the exact size as our our car. So you push back the back seat, and it gives you a full-fledged 6 feet size to put up your bed. Let me show you. Bed is put, and we'll have a good night's sleep now. Everything is here. We have just left it as it is because morning we'll make our breakfast as well, and then we'll leave from here. Okay, so catch you guys in the morning. Don't forget the view. You know, we are right in front of a water body. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see this, but here you go. This is all water. Okay, probably you'll have a better idea in the morning. So under the stars, we will have a good night's sleep. Good morning, people. So very good morning from Jabel Akhdar. We had an amazing night's sleep. It was cool and windy, and we just had our windows opened this much, and this is where we slept. You can see right behind me, we have just deflated the mattress. Quite comfortable, exact to the size of the bed. And me, Pepper, and my wife, all three of us were on the car throughout the night. And this is how we had opened a bit of window, and this was absolutely perfect. Now it's time to show you guys the view. Let me just tilt the camera. So this is where we spend our night. Look at this amazing view. So you're right on top of a mountain, around 2,800 meters. And this is what we found, a small oasis with not running water, stagnant, but hey, who can complain? And this is amazing. Let me show you from the front. So you can see the mountain top. Over here, you can see multiple people parked and camped in different campsites. And this is us. Isn't it great? Now, first order of business, we are making tea for ourselves. We'll have some tea, then we'll have our breakfast, and we'll keep you posted. Hey guys, so we are all set now. Everything is packed, including Pepper. And it's around, I think, 10 o'clock. We had our breakfast. Everything is packed. We are ready to leave now. So yeah, we start. So we're refueling the car. And the weather is nice, so we will take a bit of time to explore Jabel Akhdar. We are going towards Ananta Resort. You know, I've heard that the mountain range over that side is also amazing. So yeah, we'll fuel up, and then we'll take you on a round of Jabel Akhdar mountain range. We reach a location which is right next to a canyon, from where you can see the Jabel Akhdar village. If you can see behind me, let me just flip the camera and I'll show you. So this is the the village. You see from here to here, and you can see the step farming. So Jabel Akhdar is famous for its rose gardening. In the season, you have pomegranate and roses, which are cultivated here, and the rose water coming out of Jabel Akhdar is also very famous. And during rainy season, you can see a stream going down right from here. So it's beautiful during rainy season. Well, it's amazing right now as well. I'll just leave you without talking much and let you enjoy the nature. Guys, we are at the foothills of Jabel Akhdar mountain range. So we are in the belly of the beast. You know, we got up on the mountain from the outer side, and then we have entered in the center of Jabel Akhdar. So this is the Jabel Akhdar village, which we showed you in the last slide, which was on the top. Now we have come down, and you can see this is the bottom of the Jabel Akhdar mountain range. So you can see a village over here. Mind you, these are some very steep inclines. You know, look at this one. It's almost a 45 degree angle incline. Not 45, but at least 30, 35 degrees. But yeah, this is amazing. You can see houses over there. You can see the Jabel Akhdar village over there. And you can see some step farming over here. Amazing. As we told you, the Jabel Akhdar mountain range is famous for its rose gardening and pomegranate gardens. So one product which comes out of this place is rose water. You know, they're considered to be one of the purest rose waters available in the market. And you will see the local farmers on the roadsides selling them. So we just got a bottle for ourselves. Pure natural rose water. You still can see particles inside it, which means that this has been taken out locally right here without any industrial distillation done. So let's see how it goes. We'll check the quality and everything once we are back at home. So guys, these are so steep, downhill roads that you have these scape lanes. Now, what the scape lane is that going down on such an incline height, if you're not on a four-wheel low gear, the brake pads might lose grip and you might have a brake fail situation. So on every steep bend, you have a scape lane like this. You see the tire marks on that. So the people who have lost control or brakes on their car will just take their car in those lanes, and these are very steep inclined planes on which you have gravel, so it, the cars stick into that, and then at the end you have sand barriers. So it is installed at every nook and cranny of the steep lanes of Jabel Akhdar. So when you're driving on these roads, be very careful, and don't forget to put it on a low wheel drive. You will see a board like this, a red color board, saying serious bend and steep gradients, continue using low gear with four wheel drive. Important thing, whenever you see a board like this, put your vehicle in a four wheel mode. We have finally entered Muscat. We are on the expressway and about to take the exit for our home. It's 1:30, so we started one and a half, two hours ago. Didn't take any breaks, it was a straight 150-160 kilometers drive. We are back in Muscat now, so thank you for watching the video. And if you'd like to support us by, if you want us to make more videos like this on Oman and different places where we can take you in this beautiful country, do like and subscribe to our channel. And stay tuned, we'll be bringing you more videos from across Oman, because right now traveling internationally is not possible. So we'll try to maximize our time by exploring new places and amazing people of this country. Stay tuned. Cheers and Masalama.